2 days left until we hit June, which is guaranteed to be a wild ride of updates and reveals when it comes to not only Modern Warfare 2, but gaming just in general. We have the State of Play from PlayStation on June 2nd. We have Summer Games Fest. We have the Xbox Bethesda Showcase. June is the month for gamers, absolutely hands down, but it's also specifically going to be the month for Call of Duty fans. Welcome to the channel, everybody. Jimmy or Chaos. You may notice a new look, a new brand. That's right, the Chaos brand has a refresh, a revamp across all platforms, all media. If you guys didn't know, we don't just cover Call of Duty. We do on this channel, but we also have a Facebook page that is partnered with Facebook Gaming where we cover gaming news, trailers, leaks, rumors. We have another channel called Video Game Leaks that does the same thing. My Twitter is a constant feed of digital creator content, gaming content, entertainment and pop culture content, technology, you name it. So we wanted to come up with something that was all-encompassing for the Chaos brand. It's definitely different than anything we've done in the past, but I hope you guys enjoy it. Now, we have a stacked video today. We are going to talk about fake leaks. We are going to talk about what gameplay we are actually going to get to see when it comes to Modern Warfare 2. We're going to talk about how long does Sony and PlayStation get to hang on to their exclusivity rights for Call of Duty. That's right. And we are going to talk about the cast that is confirmed for the campaign for Modern Warfare 2. If you guys missed the video I did the other day, we talked about Modern Warfare 2 may have VR. That's right. Go check that video out after this one. So let's start off with you guys dropping a like and making sure you're subbed with all your notifications on. You definitely want those notifications on through June on this channel. Let's talk about the fake leak really quick. Now, I don't know this GGN source at all. I've seen COD Modern Warfare 2 Informer before, but really all they do is go grab leaks and scoops from like Tom Henderson and Ghost of Hope and Ralph's Valve. So I don't really kind of lean towards them at all when I'm looking for leaks and rumors. And I definitely don't the GGN source. They said June 2nd, 18 minutes into the PlayStation State of Play, we'll be seeing some Modern Warfare 2 footage. Okay, so first of all, that goes against everything that we've heard, that we would be getting a teaser trailer on June 3rd, and then the reveal on June 8th, and then gameplay on June 9th. That throws all that out of the building if it was true. And I think this is a text doc that shows, I guess, a list of the schedule for State of Play, and that's where the person put Modern Warfare 2 on there. Anyway, this account ran with it, but Ralph's Valve got on there when somebody asked him, and he said it's fake. So don't get excited. You're probably not going to see 18 minutes of gameplay of Modern Warfare 2 on June 2nd. Now, let's talk about what you are actually going to see. June 9th, Summer Games Fest. We've already got the teaser. We got the trailer reveal on June 8th. June 9th, my birthday, Ralph's Valve tweeted, Modern Warfare 2's campaign showing for Summer Games Fest has an approximate runtime of 4 minutes. Now, that's not very long, if you think about it. I think Modern Warfare 2019 showed off Clean House the entire mission, I think. I don't remember what the runtime was, but it was more than 4 minutes. Then he follows up, adding to this, everything shown will be entirely in-game footage. So for the people that say, oh, those are cinematic cutscenes, that's not part of it, this isn't truly representing the game, it looks like that's not going to be the case at all. And then Ralph says the runtime has presumably been extended to 7 minutes, preceding a brief talk with one of the narrative leads from Infinity Ward. So it looks like the narrative lead gave them permission to show more than 4 minutes, almost double that. 7 minutes. 7 minutes of actual in-game footage for Modern Warfare 2 campaign is going to give us all we need to know about how this game is going to look and feel and how immersive it's going to be, how dark, gritty, visceral, what kind of tone they're going to put with it, which I assume they're going to ramp up off of Modern Warfare 2019's tone and setting. I truly, truly do. I don't think we have anything to worry about in the department of this game looking absolutely phenomenal. So we know that. Now let's talk about how long are PlayStation users going to be at the front of the line? Now, you know that Microsoft has or is buying Activision Blizzard, which means they would own the Call of Duty franchise. They've also stated that they will honor all current deals when it comes to exclusivity and things like that. Well, Tom Henderson gave us some clarity. He said Sony's deal lasts for the next 3 games, I believe. Modern Warfare 2, Warzone 2, and Treyarch's game that they're working on for 2024. So if Microsoft obligates Sony's existing deal, which they have said they're going to do, nothing will change until COD 2025-26, depending on when that releases. Then again, we don't know if they're going to keep skipping a year. So if you have Treyarch's game in 2024, is Treyarch going to get 2025 as well, and then we get a new game in 2026? We'll have to wait and see. Now, there was a rumor out there that Modern Warfare 2 would be coming to Game Pass day one. Don't think that's probably going to happen, but a matter of fact, I don't, because it looks like they're still going to honor what PlayStation has going and actually honoring it for the foreseeable future. So if you're a PlayStation user, you're safe for now. Now, let's talk about the cast for Modern Warfare 2's campaign. And Ralph's Valve tweeted out the confirmed cast so far. The biggest one for me is hands down Price. Barry Sloan will reprise his role, and Price made Modern Warfare 2019. I mean, he was young Price, old Price. It was all phenomenal. I'm so glad he's back. Barry Sloan dives into this character. He is Price to me, and I'm just super, super glad he's back. Ghost will be Samuel Rauchen. Hope I said his name right. He's actually on Twitter. He's very active on there as well. Warren Cole, don't know exactly who he's going to be. Could be an antagonist. Vargas being played by Elaine Mesa. We have Elliot Knight, who is Gaz. We have Raya Kilstead, Laswell. And then we have Neil Elise as Soap. Now, there's going to be more characters, but they don't have any of those confirmed. And it looks like now it's confirmed that Claudia Dumais, I'm not for sure how to say her name, Farah, is going to be coming back and returning for Modern Warfare 2. She was an integral part of Modern Warfare's campaign. She had a connection to Price, so it's going to be interesting to see what they do with her. The cast is amazing. The campaign is going to be phenomenal. That's one thing I can guarantee. I don't know about multiplayer. I don't know about DMZ mode. I don't know about Warzone 2 or anything like that, but I can tell you right now, the Modern Warfare 2 campaign is going to be out of this world. The only bad thing that could happen is it's not long enough. So there you go, guys. We are not getting 18 minutes of gameplay or footage on June 2nd. We will, however, probably be getting at least 7 minutes on June 9th, my birthday. That is after we already had the teaser and the official reveal trailer. And Sony is going to be hanging on to some of those exclusivity rights for the foreseeable future. I will keep you guys updated if anything new comes. Like I said, check out all the platforms. Definitely follow me over on Twitter. That's my most active platform. And if you're into gaming updates, news, technology, entertainment, pop culture, we cover Marvel, everything over there, literally everything, give me a follow. If you're into the Facebook side of things, we cover everything games over there. If you're into just straight up leaks and rumors, whether that be 4chan leaks or it doesn't matter, we cover it over on Video Game Links. I hope you guys like the new Chaos brand. I'm proud of it. I really am. It's a new age, and we're trying to go for an all-encompassing content type brand, and I think we achieved that. So I appreciate every single one of you, and I'll see you soon.